balance beam. Now Lisa Rennie, her teammate, Lauren Campioni, at a 9.75. Their low start score so far on the beam for LSU.
I love this. She was recruited primarily for the uneven bars. And they had never seen her bounce beam. She was coming off an injury in her high school year, and she says, no, I'm really good at beam. And they just went based on what she said. And as it turned out, beam was her best event statistically. And she is very good on this event, very solid, very confident.
LSU has never beaten Alabama here in the Coleman Coliseum.
Oh, boy.
Alabama having a great competition, but they're getting all they wanted from LSU tonight.
A lot on the line for both teams.
Absolutely. This traditional SEC rivalry, it doesn't get any better than this. Score for Dana Folletti on the floor, a 9.675 after that bobbling step out of bounds. Marie Bayer now. For
from Alabama. They're always strong on this event. There's something new and different this season.
Sarah Patterson admitted they don't have as much depth as they've had in the past, but this team is performing well.
Stay in. Wow. I mean, they can't compete any better. Either team, really. There's hardly anything better they could have done so far.
All right, let's update the scores. Here's what we have for Alabama on the floor. The low score so far, which would be dropped. Remember, just 5 out of the top 6 scores. Here are the scores on the beam for LSU. Their lowest score, a 9.75. Lisa Rennie had a 9.875. Here's Kelly
Fair. But look how they fight. Just a tiny little bit off, it pulls it right back down. You're asking yourself, what kind of deduction would that be? Those tiny little things sort of add up toward the end. Because it's nothing major hitting. Half a 10.
Oh,
that's a little bit more. Nothing major, but they just start to add up.
Dee Dee Dress says, I want my young ladies to keep in the purple zone, to keep focused and think purple here in the middle of crimson territory. They are really delivering today.
There's no way she can't be just so pleased. Please, purple.
She said we're more mature this year, we're more composed. We've added some difficulty.
We're showing it.
Back to the floor now. The score for Marie Bayer was a 9.9. Two of the great performances coming up here at Alexis Brion.
Watch the power. Tumbling and difficulty too. She tumbled through, whipped back through to fight double back.
Alexis. Great athletes deliver great performances when they are needed. And now Alexis Brion will be followed up by Ashley Miles. The pressure on them to solidify this for Alabama.
Very powerful, the tumble, no music. And then boom, explode into the dance.
Great score on the beam for LSU at 9.875 for Kelly Phelan. This is close.
Tough. Both teams deserve a win here. It's really hard. They're just putting so much into every single move.
They're on their feet here at the Coleman Coliseum. We saw her a couple of weeks ago at the Super 6 get a 9-9. Probably we should expect a little higher score tonight. That was great.
Well, she just has such amazing technique. And springy as can be. And she just lights up.
The crowd has spoken. You know what they're asking for. Ashley Miles gave us a 10 earlier tonight on the vault. They're looking for another great score there as well. April Burkholder now for LSU, the final performer. They have competed beautifully under the pressure of finishing on beam. Their lowest score so far, only a 9.75. They have 3 9.875 and a 9.8.
And April's definitely putting some difficulty in this routine. Open with the layout onto the beam, and two layouts in the first pass.
The score over on the floor for Alexis Brion, 9.975.
You need to do the biggest score you can possibly come out of this is what you need. Need a big bet. Wow! Exclamation point! Oh, what a fabulous meet for all of them.
In just the third meet of the season, LSU rocking. Higher level of difficulty. And stuck landings.
Wow, that is such a hard dismount off beam. Pike doubled back. So hard to land, and look how well she did. Look at Dee Dee.
All right, to the floor, Ashley Miles. Can she give us one more 10?
Woo! With a gorgeous double layout.
Top-ranked gymnast in the country on this event, and you'll see why.
Oh, man. Yeah, you're right. I don't think you saw this at the Olympics.
Too bad, huh? The score on the beam at 9.975 for April Burkholder. So more than a 9.8 for Ashley Miles here will give them the win.
I think she's got a 9.8 in sleep, I think. If she comes out with a great landing here.
She's got to stay in bounds.
Like double back. Yeah. She jumped a little for it, but I don't think it's enough. She still came up with the good landings. Not perfect, but boy, she... lit the whole stands on fire.
What a night. Alabama, LSU.
That concludes tonight's competition.
Both looking in
the
end of the season for Gymnastics, just the third meet of the year, looking fantastic
for both teams. Just phenomenal effort.
We watch a great performance. We'll be seeing in just a minute.
How could you ask for anything more? She knows she was a little bit short, but she does double layout, double cut, lots of difficulty in this routine.
You want a pizza? Section X, row.
We'll see what they do. I don't know. It's in their hands.
She delivers big tonight with a 10 on the vault and closes out the competition with a 9.925 on the floor. We will come back and wrap all of this up in a few minutes. More from Tuscaloosa on East.
0.125 separated these two fantastic teams, and I have to say this was the best collegiate gymnastics meet I have ever seen. I have two winning coaches here. What does this say for gymnastics in the SEC and just gymnastics in general?
Well, it talks about the parity and how many really outstanding athletes we have, and just up and down everybody's lineup, and anybody can win on any given night.
And your thoughts?
Well, I just feel it was a great competition. It's like two heavyweights going at each other, and that's what it is in the SEC. It's tough competition night in and night out.
Oh.
Well, it was thrilling for us. Thank you so much for a great, great competition. Back to you, Bart.
Well, thank you, Kathy. That's collegiate gymnastics competition in the SEC. That's as good as it gets. LSU traveled to Tuscaloosa to take on the Crimson Tide and gave us all a thrill. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com. For Kathy Johnson, I'm Bart Connor. Thanks for watching Gymnastics on ESPN2. We'll see you next time.